Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're going to be taking a look at their custom visual known as the trading chart. Now, this one's very specific. It's got this primary use case of working and tracking stocks, where we're going to be able to track the open and close values for the stock by day. Also, what was the minimum and maximum it's reached, or the low and the high that stock reached by day. So we can do this over time. So it does serve a specific function, but if you actually have any other sort of process which kind of falls and meets that criteria, where you have a beginning and an end measurement daily, and you have some values in between, so the low and the high, this can be used to illustrate that. But as you can tell from the description, definitely works best with stocks. So let's go ahead and take a look at the trading chart by MAQ Software. So here in this Power BI report, we can see that we have a chart that's displaying stock prices for corresponding dates. We've got an open and close. We've got the lows and the highs and the respective dates. Now the open and the close is going to be represented by the coloration of the bars. So as we hover over this in the data labels, we can see the stock on this day opened at 100 and closed at 200. Hence, we have that green positive gain. Versus over here on this March date, it opened at 200, but it closed at 100. The underlying gray bar that goes in between represents the high and the low for that stock for that day. And you can see we do have a trending line, which follows along the closing date for each of the corresponding dates. So you can see on this negative date, we had that little bit of a dive, and we can follow that trending. Now, depending on the scenario and depending on the values that you've input, we could have some items, for instance, negative values. If you ever have negative values for the low, high, open, close, the chart actually ignores those. There's no way to offset that, so it should be noted that if you have negatives, that's the case. So in ours, we have April, May, and June. They're actually not displayed whatsoever, and we can see we have respective negative values under those specific areas. So if we scroll, we can see that there. Also, if you have some levels of inconsistency, naturally, the low value should always be less than the open and close values. And also, our high should always be greater than the open and close values as well. So if there's any inconsistencies to that, which wouldn't make sense, we're talking about data quality issues, as we can see here, they also will be ignored. As we can see, we can have some items here as far as variations on these elements. If for any reason we provide any other data type value other than the date data type, then it won't be rendered. So if for some reason that's the case, we can see here for March and April, we're having some issues, but we can see that it still displays where the data is valid. So to take a quick look at some of the formatting elements of this and how we got this designed, we can head over to the formatting pane. You'll note though, before we head there in the field pane, that we do have 6 different values here. We have the close values, open values, high values, low values, and the date, which if you do the math correctly, is actually going to be 5. Pardon me, I thought I was thinking about tooltips as well. But we have those elements here. The tooltips are kind of built in. These are all mandatory in order for this visualization to render. In the formatting area, of course, we can dictate and choose different colorations. By default, we're going to have green for positive. We're going to have red for negative. We can see the baseline indicator, which is going to be the bar in the background, which is drawn based off of the low and the high value, can be changed accordingly. So as you can see, it's been changed there. If I go back to default, it's going to get that gray. Increasing trend indicator is green by default, but if we want, we can change all of our greens to this blue. That's going to be where we ended up having our close value greater than our open value, an increase. And of course, the same can be said on the other side of things. If for some reason the close value is less than the open value, we can, instead of having it be yellow, we can have it be purple. So all of this is absolutely in our control. And of course, all the other additional formatting elements that we would want, data labels, we can change the size of this to make it a little more pronounced, font color, family, and we can have access to increase the size of legends, trends lines, the y-axis as well. All of these items at our disposal so that we can format this exactly how our end users are going to be needing. So If you're needing something for tracking changes within stock values over corresponding dates, remember if you have your open and close, your high and your low, or if you have any other sort of process that follows this trend as well, the trading chart by MAQ Software is going to be a perfect solution for you. Well, thanks for watching our video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com. Take care.